So in this series, we're talking about what is a qualifying investment. In the previous series, we were talking about what is a qualifying investor. So a qualifying investment is important, similar to a qualifying investor. Without an investment qualifying for protection, an investor, again, cannot rely on a bilateral investment treaty or domestic legislation providing for certain guarantees in relation to its investment. So where do you look at to ascertain whether your investment is a qualifying investment? So firstly, as I mentioned, bilateral investment treaties, multilateral investment treaties. Again, if you look at SADC Protocol on Finance and Investment provides for what is a qualifying investment. So you can get immovable property, you can get shareholding, you can get, so it's a wide list of qualifying so-called investments within a particular jurisdiction. But one of the most important part of a qualifying investment, so it could be one of those series of investments that are set out in a particular treaty or domestic legislation, but it's important to ensure that that investment is also an admitted investment. So what do we mean by admitted investment? So an investment is admitted if it complies with the requirements of the country in which you are investing in. So it doesn't help you to run a business which under the laws, say, of Botswana is illegal. So you might think you have an investment, but under those laws, that business or enterprise that you are conducting is an illegal activity. It's important to ensure that your investment is deemed to be admitted and is lawfully established within the particular jurisdiction. Usually, again, when host governments raise issues or defenses against an investor based on a treaty or a domestic piece of legislation providing for certain guarantees, they would raise preliminary points. As mentioned previously, the point can be on you are not a qualifying investor. The point can also be the investment that you require protection from is not a qualifying investment. So it's important to ensure that your investment that you want protection for does comply with the legal requirement of the particular jurisdiction within which you are investing in. If not, ultimately, whatever investments you've done may not be protected, and the host government will raise particular defenses against your allegation or contention that your investment qualifies for protection under a particular bilateral investment treaty or domestic piece of legislation.